This video is brought to you by Squarespace. Whether it's websites, online stores, marketing tools, or analytics, Squarespace is the all-in-one platform to make anybody go from amateur to professional. Hey, what's up, guys? JQ back with Tech Creation, where I use technology for recreation, back with another video. So earlier this year, I compared the Apple Pencil versus the Galaxy S Pen. And the reason for that unusual comparison was for two things. Number one, I basically wanted to start a discussion around who did the stylus better, Apple or Samsung. And number two was to see if a stylus is better suited for a tablet or a smartphone. And I got some pretty interesting comments in the comment section of that video. So fast forward to this video right here. I know that the best comparison would be tablet versus tablet, let's say like the Galaxy Tab S7 versus the iPad Pro. But the reason I wanted to compare Samsung DEX versus iPadOS is because I feel like what Apple is doing with their iPad and what Samsung is doing to their smartphones are two very similar visions. So on one hand, we have a tablet, which is pretty much now a laptop thanks to iPadOS and the Magic Keyboard. And on the other hand, we have just a smartphone, which by connecting it to an external display, it can easily become your tablet. So both systems have their unique use cases, and I wanted to talk about functionality, practicality, and then at the end, I'm going to give my opinion on what I think the future is best suited for. So going with a tablet in an effort to replace your desktop computer probably makes the most sense, and it's probably the most effective route, not only for its familiarity and its user base, but also just for the learning curve of a tablet. Most of us already know what a tablet is. We pretty much know how to use one already. You simply just turn it on and it's ready to go. You snap on the keyboard case and that's about it. The built-in trackpad is phenomenal. It works great. The gestures and the overall user interface of iPadOS is something that even a new beginner can get familiar with in just a matter of minutes. Whereas with Samsung DEX, it's not so straightforward. Not only do you have to have a Galaxy smartphone, I believe the Galaxy S8 and above support Samsung DEX, but you also have to have an extra monitor lying around, a power source for the monitor, whether that's a wall adapter or a power bank like this one, and then a couple of USB-C cables, and then you're good to go. And then to finish off the setup, you can add an optional mouse or keyboard. So right away, just listening to that, a lot of people are just gonna say, screw that, I'd rather just use a tablet. So while yes, this is a mobile station, it may be best suited for a stationary setup, and there's plenty of people already taking advantage of Samsung DEX at home to get work done on a daily basis. So I think it really becomes a question of, Would you rather carry a smartphone in your pocket with the ability to expand it to any display you want? Or would you rather carry a 12.9-inch tablet in your backpack at all times? I guess it's really gonna come down to the individual. And personally, I understand both types of users, but I actually might relate to the smartphone user more because let's face it, smartphones now, especially the Galaxy Note 20 Ultra, with the S Pen is already productive as hell, and you can get so much work done in the palm of your hand. I mean, you can sign documents, you can draw, you can send emails, you can do light photo editing. There's just so much you can already do with your smartphone that I wouldn't blame anyone who feels that, you know, they can save some of the desktop stuff for when they get home, as opposed to always carrying a tablet with them, because maybe they may not always need the screen real estate at all times. So the Note 20 Ultra with a 6.9-inch screen just might get you through the day. And then when you come home, you can switch to tablet mode by simply just plugging it in and you're good to go. Now on the other side, obviously carrying a tablet is just so much more cleaner than having to carry a monitor, a power bank, cables, maybe a mouse and keyboard, etc., etc. Basically, Samsung wants your desktop to be in your pocket, whereas Apple wants your iPad to just be your laptop. I don't think they're trying to replace the Mac entirely, which is why iPadOS, although it is in its own category, it falls more in line with a smartphone or mobile environment. It doesn't have that traditional desktop environment and can't exactly compete with macOS just yet. So with that out the way, now we have to look at the capabilities and features of each of these hybrids, which basically comes down to software. I think we all know which one comes out on top here, and that is iPadOS, simply because it's been out longer, it's had more time to be polished, and it just works, and it works really well. Aside from customization, we pretty much get all of the essentials that we can ask for in a laptop replacement or a PC experience. So connecting external hard drives or peripherals, we get that. And because of its ease of use and simplicity, it's going to be the option that most people will go for because it can pretty much do everything you need it to do aside from any like high-end production. Now, one of the iPad Pro's features being Apple's sidecar. It has its time and place of use, but personally, it's not a feature that I find myself using too much. Also, Apple's sidecar does support a wireless connection, which is very similar to Samsung DEX wireless for your television, which are both pretty cool in theory, but not very practical due to latency and lag. Whereas with Samsung DEX, it has limits of its very own, and the main one just being software optimization. So since this is just simply an extension of your smartphone, whatever your smartphone can't do, neither can Samsung DEX. So while the iPad Pro with iPadOS is the more polished, optimized, and refined solution, Samsung DEX, on the other hand, is so much more like a PC with its desktop-like environment. It's an interface that pretty much anyone who's used a Windows computer will be able to self-navigate. So in a very funny way, iPadOS is easier to use than Samsung DEX, but Samsung DEX is also easier to use than iPadOS, if that makes sense. And so with the traditional desktop layout comes a true desktop level experience, including true multitasking. So you can open several windows at once, you can sort out your icons on the desktop, along with the ability to resize your windows as well. Support for right click is also supported, just like it works on an actual desktop. And since Samsung DEX is pretty much Android, you get all of the same system level flexibility as you would on your phone. So things like setting a wallpaper is pretty straightforward, and being able to navigate the root folder structure of your file manager is just far superior. Unlike with iPadOS, you can only really multitask with two windows open at once. The Files app has improved tremendously, but it's just not flexible. So you won't get access to like the true internal storage of your device, as I just mentioned with Samsung DEX. Now, the downside to DEX is that heavier tasks like video editing or audio production that the iPad Pro can easily handle is not exactly practical on this machine. I wouldn't say it's more so software, but it's just simply there's a huge power difference. Smartphones are not yet as powerful as tablets, but the day that that comes, then this whole hybrid setup here is going to be a serious competitor. The nice thing about Samsung DEX is it's pretty much like a smartphone PC. Therefore, you can run almost any smartphone app in a desktop environment, along with the ability to send text messages and make phone calls. So though it's not as good as iMessage, it's very similar to the experience of using an iPad, being able to use iMessage and FaceTime on your tablet. So aside from Samsung DEX not being as matured or as polished as iPadOS, the real big downside here is simply just having to carry around all of the extra peripherals and cables with you along with your smartphone. You know, and in a very strange way, it's almost like the iPad with iPadOS is Apple's Samsung DEX, because think about it, we take our smartphone, we plug it in, and now we just have a bigger version of our smartphone. In a way, thanks to Apple's continuity features like, you know, iMessage being in sync, your copy and paste features being in sync, if I had my iPhone with me, I can just put it down and then continue using my iPad. So it's almost like I'm using a bigger version of my iPhone, and that's pretty much what we're doing here with a Galaxy phone and a bigger monitor. Now, the best part about both of these is that the Samsung browser on Samsung DEX supports full PC style desktop class browsing, and the same is true for Safari on the iPad Pro. So regardless of which of these hybrids you choose, it makes editing your website with Squarespace a breeze. With a wide variety of templates to get started, whether your business involves photography, weddings, restaurants, blogging, online stores, professional services, or events, Squarespace has you covered, along with a ton of built-in tools such as SEO, analytics, e-commerce, email campaigns, domains, hosting, free webinars, and 24/7 support. Squarespace is the one-stop shop to make anybody go from amateur to professional. So go ahead and check out squarespace.com to get started with your free trial. And when you're ready, make sure you use my special code squarespace.com/techcreation to get 10% off the purchase of your first website or domain. I think one of the most practical use cases for a device like this is best suited when you're using a phone like the Galaxy Note, because you can look at all of your detailed drawings that you did with the S Pen on a much bigger canvas and then open up an app like Adobe Photoshop and make any fine tuning or corrections from there on. So this setup still has a lot of potential for creators. And obviously the Apple Pencil on a tablet is much better. But again, we're not comparing tablets, we're comparing methods here. So just keep that in mind. Personally, what I would like to see in the future, I might be crazy, but Thunderbolt 3 or USB-C 4 on the iPad Pro and or tablet-like power on Galaxy smartphones. I can only imagine what the potential of both of these hybrid systems would look like in 10 years from now. So I want to open up the question to you guys. Which of these methods of future computing do you guys think will excel the most within, like, let's say the next 10 years or so? Do you guys see more potential in Samsung DEX, or do you guys see more potential in the iPad Pro with iPadOS? Let me know down below in the comment section. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you show some love to that like button, subscribe, and turn on the alerts. This way YouTube notifies you whenever I drop another awesome tech video. As always, I want to thank each and every one of you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next video.